Cognos Analytics now has time awareness in the assistant. You can ask the assistant questions with a time context, even if your dataset doesn't have those specific columns. You just need a date column. For example, you can now ask the assistant to show values for the last quarter or 3 days after Christmas. In this video, you'll see several different examples of time-aware questions that can now be asked. I downloaded the Coffee Chain 2020 to 2022 dataset from the Accelerator Catalog and used that to create a data module. This is going to be the starting point for my demonstration of how to use time awareness in the assistant. The dataset contains a full year's worth of data for 2022. I'm recording this video on April 21st. The dashboard is meant to represent April to date sales in the summary on the far left. I've included a table of daily April sales just to use as reference points when I'm validating and demonstrating the assistant results. To get this, I've added a filter at the top to get only April 1st to April 21st data because I'm recording this video on the 21st, and I'm excluding all future data transactions. If you're following along and going to replicate this video at some future date, then you would use the appropriate filter value. The scenario I'm looking at is I've got the aggregated sales amount on the left for April, and I want to do a bit of ad hoc exploration. And for that, I'm going to use the assistant. To start the assistant, I click the icon. The assistant window opens up. First question I'm going to ask is, what was my sales yesterday? And I can see it's 608. And if I go over and look in the table, I can see yesterday's value was 608. I can also ask in context of a week, show me sales from last Monday, 127. I can see that that's the Monday of the current week that I'm in. I can drill into the result by asking additional questions that I would have asked in previous releases. For example, if I went across and added up all the values that were reported for each of the product types, I would see that they would add up for the $1,163 worth of sales that I have for today. If I wanted to see what my sales were for a quarter, I could say, show me sales for last quarter by month. And the assistant knows the previous quarter in context of today was the first quarter, so January, February, March. Now notice that the graphic shows it in alphabetic order. If I wanted to change that, I can always drag the visualization onto the canvas and apply a sort. If I wanted to look further back in time, I could ask, show me sales for last quarter of 2021 by month. And I can have a look at the filter that was created. So I can see that the assistant knows the fourth quarter of 2021 runs from October 1st till December 31st. If I wanted to see sales for the first week of March, I could ask a question. An assistant has created the filter of going from the 7th of March through the 13th of March. So keep in mind what it's doing is it's taking the first Monday in March that it finds, and that's establishing the start of the week. If I had a timestamp or date time column instead of just a date column, I could ask even finer grained time questions. So for example, I could say, give me inventory today at 14:15. And my result would be filtered for 2:15 p.m. Since I just have a date column, if I ask that question, my inventory result would be for the full day. The assistant's also aware of American holidays. So for example, I could ask, show top three products by sales on the first week after Christmas last year. And you can see that the filter's been created going from December 27th till January 2nd. So that's the first week following Christmas in 2021. I can also ask the assistant future dated questions. For example, I could ask, show me budget sales. So what's my target? And you can see that the assistant has created the filter for September 5th and shows me what my forecasted sales are going to be. Here are additional examples of time-aware questions you might want to ask. This concludes the video on the time awareness feature that was introduced with Cognos Analytics 11.2.2. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.